Inshallah, my lecture tonight will be about the Aqeedah of Ahl-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah. And this topic is very important, and we need to repeat this topic. Why? Because this is the most important thing we have, which is the Aqeedah, our belief, our Iman, our faith. Without the Aqeedah, I mean without a correct faith, your deeds will not be accepted. You cannot live in the life properly. And for example, why people commit suicide? Because there is a mistake in their aqidah. There is a deficiency in their belief. Why the mu'min, the strong believer, never he will commit this. He will not commit suicide. He will say always, the Muslim always says, Alhamdulillah. Something good or something bad, he will say Alhamdulillah. صح? Alhamdulillah ala kulli hal, or Alhamdulillah alladhi bi ni'mati tatammu salihat. Alhamdulillah for the Alhamdulillah alladhi bi ni'mati tatammu salihat, for the good things, and for those bad things, Alhamdulillah ala kulli hal. Because of what? Because of the aqidah. So inshallah, I will go through the aqidah, okay, some issues, or the pillars of iman. Because some scholars, like when they speak about the aqidah, they speak about the pillars of iman, which are mentioned by the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When Jibreel asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "What is iman?" Jibreel asked the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in front of the Sahaba, Mal iman, what is iman? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him the six pillars. I am going down by the chair. Okay, please, can you check the camera? Is it okay? Huh? Can you adjust the? It's all right. It's all right, huh? Because I'm going down by the chair. Jazakallah khair. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, answered the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, answered Jibreel, Al-Iman an tu'mina billahi wa malaikati wa kutubihi wa rusulih wal yawm al-akhir wa tu'min bil qadar khayrihi wa sharrihi. He said, what is the definition of Iman? What is the meaning of Iman? To believe in Allah, his angels, his books, his messengers, the last day, and to believe, I'm translating the hadith.
أنا
بالنسبة لي مريح.
مريح.
مريح. إيه.
إذا هذا أفضل.
يلا. ما عندي مشكلة.
الله يجزيك خير.
جزاك الله خير. يعطيك العافية. ممتاز. تمام. Okay, exactly the hadith, the Prophet ﷺ repeated the verb only for the last one, which is which pillar of Iman? The last one, al-Qadr, the decree. Okay, the destiny. Why? Inshallah, I will mention later. Okay, let's see these six pillars of Iman. كم دقيقة شيخ عندنا؟
عندك إن شاء الله. عندنا الساعة السابعة.
سابعة. طيب، جزاكم الله خير. أسأل الله يتقبل منكم. الأمر الأول، the first issue، أن تؤمن بالله. سبحان الله، يعني like الشيخ معثيمين، he has a very small book, not very beneficial. Explaining the six pillars of Iman. He mentioned when you speak about أن تؤمن بالله, this part, we should speak about four things. To believe in the existence of Allah, to believe in the lordship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the uluhiyya, the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to worship Him, and in the names and attributes of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay? And mainly, you notice maybe the books of Aqeedah, They concentrate on the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that he deserved worship alone. Yeah, and the prayer should be only for Allah, the slaughtering the cow for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, sujood, ruku', siyam, all the deeds should be only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But now, okay, we need to speak about the first one also, the existence of Allah. This is very dangerous, wallahi. I will not say only here in the non-Muslim countries. Even in our world, I mean the Arab world, we started to hear more that people deny the Khaliq. They deny the Creator. Subhanallah. Because of what? Because the media now is open. The problem, people don't listen to the Quran and Sunnah. They listen to the non-Muslims. They claim that, wallah, they have the logic. There is no logic in the Quran. The Quran and the Islam wants us to follow the rules of Allah blindly. Wallahi, this is a disaster. And maybe you know this more than me. How people deny Al-Khaliq. They deny Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They don't believe in Allah. Maybe they pray, they recite Quran, but they don't believe in the existence of Allah. So we have to emphasize this point because it is part of our religion. Maybe from the childhood. Yeah, mashallah, like this boy, mashallah. How many old? Three, five? Mashallah. We teach him. Who created the sun? Allah. Khalas, repeat this. Repeat with him. Rizq, from where? From Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The sustenance from Allah. If I am sick, the cure from where? From Allah. And I can add with what I'm teaching him some verses from the Quran. وَإِذَا مَرِضْتُ فَهُوَ يَشْفِينَ. It is clear. If I am sick, he, subhanahu wa ta'ala, only Allah, will cure me. It is clear in the Quran. Tamam? إشفي أن تش in the dua, for example. He has temperature, high temperature. He has fever. Okay? Before you give him Panadol, give him aqeedah. Tell him, make dua. We can't teach our son. يعني, subhanallah, now, how many, يعني, what we are teaching our children, math, physics, chemistry, صح? So what is the problem if you teach your son short dua? If he is sick, أذهب الباس رب الناس, إشفي أنت الشافي لا شفاء إلا شفاءك, شفاء لا يغادر سقما. I teach my son or my daughter, when they are sick, oh my daughter, oh my son, say, before we go to the doctor, say this dua, أذهب الباس رب الناس, oh the Lord of people, remove the disease from me, cure me, you are the one who cures, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Okay, so by this you emphasize the point, which is the existence of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Where is Allah? We don't see Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We see him in the Jannah. Repeat this. Repeat this. And of course, they don't want us to teach our children these concepts. Why? Because they believe in materials. صح? They believe in something they can touch, they can see, they can smell, they can taste. They don't want our children, the new generation, to believe in the unseen. Do you agree with me or no? They want to teach our children to deny the unseen. Why? If you read the beginning of the Quran, what is the first page or the second page in the Quran? Open the Quran. What is the second page? يُنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ سُورَةُ الْبَقَرَةِ ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِيهِ هُدًى لِلْمُتَّقِينَ الَّذِينَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِالْغَيْبِ. Those who believe in the unseen. So this is part of our religion. To believe in al-ghayb, the unseen. I know the challenge here is strong, but we have to fight to protect our children. This is your responsibility. I mentioned yesterday in the lecture, okay, when I spoke about raising children, I said, as the Prophet said, this is your responsibility. Raising your children, don't say, wallahi, this is the responsibility of the society or of the imam of the masjid, the school. You are responsible. So, the existence of Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala, there is a saying from a very simple Bedouin man. When they asked him, how you came to know Allah? How you came to know that there is a creator for the creation? He said, it is very simple. البعرة تدل على البعير والأثر يدل على المسير بحار ذات أمواج وأرض ذات فجاج ألا تدل على اللطيف الخبير. He said, very simple. If you walk in the desert and then you see the feces, the stool of the camel, it means there was a camel here. If you see the footprint, it means there was somebody was walking here. صح? So, these seas and long and wide earth, all of them lead us to what? To a creator, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So please, take it very simple. Don't try to complicate it. It is bad. Islam is simple. Islam is simple. Islam not only for doctors and engineers. Islam for anyone. For Arabs, non-Arabs. For educated, for illiterate. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Nabi al-Ummi. He doesn't know how to write or read. Not only him, also many of the Sahaba, radiallahu ta'ala. Do you think that all the Sahaba were writing the wahi, the revelation? Ali, Muawiyah radiallahu ta'ala, Abdullah ibn Amr al-As, they were writing. But many of the Sahaba don't know how to write. Very simple. So number one, and the belief of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to believe in Allah, it means existence of Allah. Number two, the lordship of Allah. It means, it is called in Arabic, the scholars say, Tawheed al-Rububiyyah. Okay? What is Tawheed al-Rububiyyah? Who can tell me what is Tawheed al-Rububiyyah? The lordship of Allah. Yes, please. Oneness of? Yes, this is more accurate. Jazakallah khair. صح, it is oneness. But this is more accurate. توحيد الله بأفعالي. To believe that there are actions only belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like, who gives the death and life? Only Allah. Who gives the rain? Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who cures? Only Allah. This is called توحيد الربوبية. To believe in the actions of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Who knows the unseen, al-ghayb, who knows the future? Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is called Tawheed al-Rububiyyah. We have to believe in this. And mainly there was no problem between the Prophet ﷺ and the people of Quraysh in this kind of Tawheed. If you ask them, it is mentioned in the Quran, if you ask him who created the heavens and the earth, they will submit, they will agree with you that Allah created them. SubhanAllah, now even the disbelievers now may be worse than the disbelievers at the time of Rasulullah. I think now if you ask them who created the heavens and the earth, what they will say? Huh? Now the disbelievers, they say, At-tabi'ah, the nature. Huh? They will say, Sudfa. SubhanAllah, everything came by chance. SubhanAllah. So this is Tawheed al-Rububiyyah. The third point, Tawheed al-Uluhiyyah. And this is also very important. All our deeds should be pure. Only